आराधना एंड आई एम एट गॉड्स ओन कंट्री. जी हाँ, मैं हूँ केरला में एंड राइट नाउ आई एम एट द कैपिटल ऑफ केरला, दैट इज त्रिवेंद्रम, द एवरग्रीन सिटी. स्वामी टेम्पल जो केरला के सबसे पुराने मंदिरों में से है और इसे इंडिया का सबसे richest मंदिर भी माना जाता है. I am also here to borrow some wealth. That is the wealth of some soul searching. Bye.
Don't be the God's own country, probably because of it has got the natural beauty of about 500 kilometers of golden beach, 44 rivers flowing crisscross, green and very dense forest. That makes Kerala the most sought for destination for the tourists to come to this state.
So basically, I'm here for two things. One for all that's scenic and one for all that's music. और music से मुझे याद आया, मेरे पास आप लोग के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा surprise है. So come with me. To reveal the surprise, I am here to introduce you to India's musical gift to the world. She is a sitarist and a music composer. Yes, I'm talking about the immensely talented Anoushka Shankar. Anoushka hai Trivandrum mein aur wo yahan perform karne wali hai Kerala ke most beautiful music or dance festival Nisha Gandhi mein. Anoushka, welcome to Kerala. Is it your first time here?
No, it's actually my third time.
All right.
Yeah.
How are you feeling being in Kerala?
Really happy. It's been a gap of a few years.
Okay.
And I love it here, so it's wonderful to be back.
Oh, brilliant, brilliant. Yeah. Of course, we're also very happy to have you here. Also, Anoushka, I'd like to ask you that Kerala, as they say, is God's own country and music is his own language. How does it feel to be a musician here?
I mean, it's lovely. I feel like my two previous experiences of playing in Kerala were wonderful. I have great memories of really music-loving audiences here.
Right.
And so, yeah, I'm really looking forward to that.
Oh, very nice. So here for a concert. Now, I've heard you compose your own lyrics, you make music. What do you enjoy doing the most and why?
I mean, for me, all of those things are part of making music, and that's what I love.
Correct.
So for me, whether that is, like you said, writing lyrics, writing melodies, I love working with other people. That
yes,
might be one of my favorite things.
Okay.
That moment of chemistry with someone
Absolutely.
Else when we're working together, that's maybe one of my favorites. But also just to be on stage,
on
playing
stage,
for people.
I'm sure.
That's
exhilarating, must be like
an ultimate magic.
Wow,
yeah.
Wow. Also, tell me something. Do you think nature, spirituality, and music, they're all connected? And if yes, like how does it feel to be a musician and also to be spiritual at the same time?
Well, our Indian classical music has its roots in spirituality.
Absolutely.
So there is a deep connection there.
Yeah.
And I do find music, like most art forms, to be something that can be very spiritual. It's definitely somewhere where I connect to sense
yeah.
of spirituality. In fact, it's been like a real place of learning for me to know what to even recognize about a spiritual path. It really came to me from my music, I think.
From your music. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's nice. Now, Anoushka, your creations are usually a fusion of music from all across the world.
And the result is as stunning as Kerala, which is also a mix of nature, art and heritage.
I want to know more forms of blending that you do with music. Like, is there any other way you blend your music?
Well, for me, I come from Indian classical music, so for the first many years, that was what I learned and what I played. And so I think having that strong grounding in one form gave me enough of a base from where to start.
Yeah.
And so that's very much at the heart of everything I do, you know. So even when I work with Western classical music or electronica or jazz, flamenco, you know, the Indian music is where I'm coming from. So that's always a part of it.
Yeah.
And I think when you have like that kind of strong grounding somewhere, it really helps you.
It helps you. Mold into different,
absolutely,
like, fuse music together.
Yeah.
Tell me something about your latest album, Home.
Well, Home actually for me has been, like, after a decade of making albums that were and have been crossover, experimental, Home for me was where I suddenly just realized it had been too long since I'd made a purely classical album. And I wanted to just come back and make an album of Indian ragas. So it's a purely classical album, but it's recorded at a very unusually sort of high definition level. So a very modern recording of very traditional music,
if you will.
And it was really meaningful for me to get to do that.
Brilliant. Now, you've just finished recording your latest album, Land of Gold. So I think the name is very interesting and intriguing. Can you tell me something about it?
It was coming from the idea that every person has some kind of a dream or vision that you could call your own land of gold, like some kind of a dream of what you want, whether it's simply safety and security or happiness. And the music was really influenced by the refugee crisis I was seeing over the last year, and that's where a lot of the music was coming from. And that's where it sort of evolved, that you were seeing thousands and millions of people trying to come to a place of safety. And it was that idea of, like, I have what I could call my land of gold. I've got safety, I've got healthy family, and just the idea that that's what everyone is striving for.
Absolutely, like, we're all looking for that one safe place. So.
Exactly.
Well, that's very interesting. Anoushka, one of our very popular albums is called Traveler. How do you associate with this word? Like,
I mean, for me, I grew up across continents. I was born in London, I lived in Delhi, I lived in California.
Wow.
And so I was kind of always moving as a person and then on tour as well. Yeah. So I was always a traveler. And I've always been quite fascinated by that in other people as well.
Yeah.
So that album was an exploration of the gypsy musicians who had traveled from India eventually to Spain. And so it was a crossover between Indian music and flamenco. But I think I've always been fascinated by people who live across cultures.
Anoushka's musical journey in Kerala continues on the other side. Stay tuned. Nature's music is never over. The silences are pauses, and beauty is the melody. We're in Kerala, where I'm having a conversation with the musical genius Anoushka Shankar.
Anoushka, you've always been traveling with your father, and now you travel with your sons. Now, is this a conscious effort to relive memories, like?
It's not so much a conscious effort to relive anything as much as just my family being a part of my life. I'm a touring musician and I have kids, and so my kids are part of my life.
Absolutely.
They don't come with me on all my tours, but I try and bring them with me when I can. One of them is here with me now, and it's lovely, yeah.
So Anoushka, when not behind the sitar, what do you do in such a rich and diverse place such as Kerala? I really want to know your itinerary.
Just hanging out. I mean, I have a bit of rehearsal and stuff before the show. But also, I'm really looking forward to the meal we're going to have. I haven't had, like, traditional Kerala food for a long time. And I want to show my son stuff like the dance and the music, the martial arts. There's so many things that come from here. So I'm really looking forward to showing him a lot of that.
So we know that you've planned for 1 year. So we want to know what's beyond that.
I am. I'm actually booked till, I even have some show bookings in 2018 already.
What?
It's really crazy. Some places, especially in the West, once you're playing in, like, opera houses and concert halls, they book really far in advance.
Oh my.
So we often book 2, sometimes 3 years in advance. So it's really crazy. So I know my whole 2017 is fully like mapped out where I'm going to be when and all of that. Wow. So it's a full tour for Land of Gold around the world. Wow. 2017, like it's less developed. We've got a few shows plotted in and I'll, outside of that, start working on another album, I suppose.
That's brilliant. We can't wait for you to come out another one. You've got 2 lovely children. Please tell me how are you finding managing 2 little cute little...
It's amazing. I think it's the most insane and crazy thing I've ever done in my life. It's mental. I adore it, but it's the hardest thing I've ever done. Like, these 2 kids are amazing, but my God, I haven't slept in 5 years. Like, I haven't slept a whole night. Except sometimes I look forward to going on tour because at least I'll sleep a little bit more. You know, it's like, it's crazy. But I love it. Zubin's almost 5 and Mo is almost 1. So he's 10 months old. And it's fun. There's a lot of laughter. We laugh a lot, and
that's a good thing.
My husband and I are both like really goofy people. So it's fun with kids. You kind of can actually you can allow yourself to be as silly as you want to be.
Absolutely.
Because that's good with kids.
Lovely, yeah.
It's really nice. It's really nice.
Lastly, before leaving, any last words for Kerala?
Last words about Kerala. I mean, I think this is an incredibly beautiful, special place that we have here. You know, it's somewhere that, in particular, like all my friends around the world, it's the one place where they go, oh, I really want to go to Kerala. Yes. I really want to see Kerala. It's so special, and I'm happy to be here, and I look forward to coming back.
So Anoushka, we're not done with you. We have a little surprise coming up for you.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you excited?
I'm scared.
No, don't be scared. So after an amazing chat with Anoushka, we are here to try out some traditional Kerala food, and for that I'd like to call Chef Prakash Nayak, who has been running the Niraamaya Retreats kitchen since 2010. He's also running a cooking school, and let's see what Chef has to teach us today.
Namaskaram.
Namaskaram.
Namaskaram, sir.
How are you?
Well, thank you.
So we prepared a special meal for you, traditional Kerala sadhya.
Lovely. Brilliant. Thank you.
After getting a pure taste of Kerala, Anoushka's curiosity about the local culture led us to a scintillating dance performance called Mohini Attam. God's own country was showing us its vast and vivid colors. Up next, music ruled our hearts when a group of young men and women played the 300 years old percussion instrument, chenda. Down the ancient lane wasn't over just as yet. Anoushka was to witness the age-old martial art form, Kalaripayattu. And as the sun met the distant shore at the backdrop, the Kalaripayattu fighters got into a classic combat. Thank you.
magical day it has been. A mesmerizing meet with Anoushka, a mouth-watering sadhya, and mind-blowing performances. If you ever wish to witness heaven in this lifetime, think no further. Come to Kerala.